Microlecture 16, The Age of Revolution and Its Background. The origins of revolutions in the Atlantic world were complex and diverse. There is no single cause behind them. Moreover, none of these revolutions was inevitable. However, it is well known that social, economic, and political crises eroded the authority of colonial states. Additionally, ideas derived from the Enlightenment and the imperial competition and warfare set the stage for the transformation of the Atlantic at this time. In the 18th century, European societies were legally divided into groups with a special privilege like the nobility and the clergy, and groups that had to work really hard to survive like artisans and peasants. Most nobles were landowners who used their economic power to consolidate their political hegemony. These wealthy classes enjoyed tax exemptions and had privileges like free time and leisure. In most countries, there were also middle classes who enjoyed privileges that allowed them to monopolize all sorts of economic activity. At this time, the European population grew fast and cities and towns were becoming more populated. There was an increase in schooling and a raise in literacy rates, particularly among urban men. The downside of this urban explosion was that prices went up and common folks struggled to find affordable food and living space. Most people's logical solution was to work harder and for longer hours, but that made them unhappy. Economic growth created new inequalities between rich and poor. While the poor struggled with rising prices, investors grew rich from the spread of rural manufacturers and overseas trade. With the economic growth associated with international trade, the distinctions between landed elites and merchants' elites began to disappear. Enterprising nobles put money into trade, and rising middle classes bureaucrats and merchants bought land estates and noble titles. Marriages between nobles and the wealthy educated bourgeoisie served the interests of both groups. Another crucial social change experienced at this time involved the racial regimes established in European colonies. By the late 18th century, European law accepted that only Africans and people of African descent were subjects to slavery. Even free people of color, a term for non-enslaved people of African or mixed African descent, were subject to significant restrictions on their legal rights. The racial privilege conferred a new dimension of entitlement on European settlers in the colonies, and they used ruthless methods to enforce it. In Spanish America and Brazil, people of European and African descent intermingled with the vast indigenous population. The whole continent demography changed, and mestizos became a new racial category with more privilege than the indigenous people and people from African descent, but less than the pure blood European. In addition to the demographic and social changes, new political ideas were vigorously spreading around the world. The notions of liberty and equality helped fuel revolutions in the Atlantic world. The call for liberty was, first of all, a call for individual human rights. The main supporters of the cause of individual liberty, the liberals, demand freedom to behave according to the dictates of their conscience, the end of censorship, freedom from arbitrary laws, and from judges who obey orders from the government. The call for liberty was also a call for a new form of government with legitimacy and sovereignty. Reformers believed people had the authority to make laws limiting an individual's freedom of action. In practice, this government system meant choosing legislators who represent the people and were accountable for them. Equality is an even more complex idea. In the 18th century, thinkers and philosophers argued that, in theory, all citizens should have equal rights and liberties. However, they made gender, class, social, and racial distinctions that made the idea unpractical. The most remarkable example of this is women's rights. Plenty of women were instrumental and decisive during the Atlantic Revolution. Still, the men in power limit their legal political rights, such as voting, run for office, and participate in government. The second significant example is that of race. Despite promoting equality narratives, most of these Europeans did not question white people's imagined superiority over people of color. People from indigenous or African descent were for centuries considered inferior. The third aspect to consider is that liberals never believed everyone should be equal economically. significant differences between rich and poor were perfectly acceptable so long as every free white male had a legally equal chance at an economic gain. The Atlantic revolutions began with aspirations for equality and liberty among the social elites. Very quickly, these ideas became a widespread phenomenon in which revolutionaries from different sectors of the population started to claim their rights. Depending on location, their demands included political rights for women and free people of color, the emancipation of slaves, better treatment of indigenous peoples, and government regulations to reduce inequality. The Atlantic revolutions were characterized by bitter conflicts over how far reform should go and to whom it should apply. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.